clear to go.
You're clear.
Coming. Nozzle swing.
There we go. Smoke
shift rope. Get ignition.
Altitude.
Here we go. 3, 2, 1, release.
Awesome.
I'm gonna hold level for a minute here.
Say 3-6, we're in a hold here.
Flight controls to G, look good.
2-G's.
2-G's, copy.
Whenever a NASA aircraft leaves the ground, an entire team of people ensure that it executes its mission safely and successfully. The pilot and mission controller sit at the ends of a complex stream of data, along which dozens of IT specialists, engineers, and technicians work to ensure that each in-flight decision is informed by accurate information, and that all test or science data is successfully gathered and processed. At the Armstrong Flight Research Center, this team makes up the Mission Information and Test Systems Directorate, known simply as Code M, a critical behind-the-scenes force that helps Armstrong keep its reputation as one of the world's finest flight research centers. In most cases, new flight projects first approach the Mission Integration Office, or MIO. The MIO is responsible for the development of partnerships with key researchers, mission directorates, and external stakeholders. They help create value for our partners by providing an initial interface and a cross-functional integration of processes, capabilities, and operations.
And there's 10,000 feet.
I'm going to go about 100 feet above you if I can, yeah.
Okay.
Flights of new aircraft or systems are first simulated to ensure that any novel concepts are working as designed, or to conduct trade studies, or to iterate a design towards optimum performance. Later, when an actual flight is scheduled, before the aircraft even revs its engines, simulation familiarizes the pilot and mission control team with the procedures and test points, and prepares them for unexpected situations. Engineers and technicians in Code ME, the simulation engineering branch of Code M, create one-of-a-kind simulation programs and hardware subsystem interfaces that enable NASA's pilots and their industry partners to understand how a new aircraft or system will handle, or discover the most efficient ways to hit their data points.
Paul, I'm going to light the burners just for a second here, just see the difference in the thrust.
All right. So the cable tension go up a little bit into the red.
Alright, coming out of the afterburners, back to full power.
Yep, there's some slack.
Yeah, and some slack on the rope there.
Oh yeah, it's amazing. Now that I'm getting kind of used to the sim, I can really feel you back there and the effects.
That would make sense.
Ready to send check.
Sending check command now.
Send arm.
Arming now.
Ready to send terminate.
And terminating now. And we have a good arm term cycle.
Well before the research flight phase, the range engineering branch, Code MC, engineers and software developers build, integrate, and verify range assets. This is how they ensure the aircraft telemetry can be received and processed for control room display monitoring, that aircraft position can be tracked for situational awareness.
All right, this is TD on data 2. Go ahead and check everybody to their control room display status now that we have both engines up.
Heard you loud and clear.
And that control room voice communications are working. For unmanned aircraft, Code MC verifies uplinks for command and control and flight termination systems.
We're gonna arm and terminate.
Slavings routed for the guy.
We're high.
Got him.
Break release.
And the squawk is a little off if you have to use it by about 5 degrees. Don't know.
Tracking the aircraft while it's in flight is the responsibility of MR, the Range Operations Branch. From working with the U.S. Air Force, which controls Edwards airspace, to scheduling flights, to keeping radar dishes locked on a supersonic airplane, to tracking that airplane with long-range optics, Code MR is responsible for getting the data from the airplane to the ground. This branch operates the telemetry tracking systems, space positioning systems, audio communication systems, video systems, mission control center, and mobile systems. After a flight, the data arrives at the Information Services Branch, or Code MI, which provides information technology solutions for NASA's workforce, everything from desktops to internet connections. Code MI also manages Armstrong's data center and network infrastructure, ensuring the right data is available to the appropriate users, from routine email to specialized mission-specific flight data. Finally, MI provides multimedia services, from graphic artists, photographers, and videographers, to web and repro. These skilled individuals ensure effective communication of the many activities and accomplishments of the center. These services include airborne photography and videography, specialty services driven by the demands of flight research. The multimedia products help make this information accessible to engineers, researchers, partners, and stakeholders around the center, around the agency, and out in the public. A strong team with an important role. The Mission Information and Test Systems Directorate helps separate the real from the imagined through flight.